Don't you cry, and don't you fret. You can bet one lucky day you'll wake up, and your blues will be forsaken. One lucky day, lovely love will come your way.
Greetings. I am Sri Master Gano Grills for Galighticus.com, and today's video is about gratitude, one of my favorite words. I'm going to show you something. This is my wallet, and inside of my wallet, I've been carrying around this. It's a little tattered, but how many of you can guess what this is? This is a cassette insert from the 1975 album of Earth, Wind, and Fire's Gratitude. And, you know, I've been carrying this around for over 20 years in my wallet. Now, you guys can call me nuts, but this is a personal reminder for me to always be in a state of gratitude. Now, when I heard that album, it's one of my favorite albums. It's one of my all-time favorite collection of Earth, Wind, and Fire songs. One side of the album is recorded on the road, and the other side of the album are brand new studio tracks. And the thing that I love about that album is that it is an answer to a universal question. Are you grateful? The answer was yes. And Maurice White was the one who came up with the answer to give to his adoring public and fans, which was gratitude. It's something that we haven't really seen done, where an album was released in the early part of 1975 and at the end of 1975 to show gratitude for the grand success of the previous album, which was labeled That's the Way of the World. I've spoken about that many times, but I wanted to give more of a personal look at what gratitude means and what it can be in your life. There are people that complain about everything. There are people who have a fragility of character. What does that mean? I consult a lot of people every day, and there are some people that are very, very fragile in their ego. And they perceive when someone has a very, very clear line of thought, or they perceive that as a threat, forceful, or they perceive it as a potential offense. When someone is very clear about what it is that they offer, what they do, or who they are, it is not to be perceived as something that should cause you to be offended. And there are people in the world who are constantly looking for an occasion, as Wayne Dyer said, God bless the dead. He would say, stop looking for a reason to be offended. If you are one of those people who are constantly offended or looking for a reason to be affronted, you have a fragility of character. It's something that you may want to repair. I remember one time I was on the train, and there were some dancers that got on the train. I saw something that was very interesting. I like to study people. And there was a red-haired 17-year-old, 18-year-old kid that got on. And one of his friends jokingly put his hand in his face and mushed him. He just kind of ran his hand all over his face. And the guy who had the hand in his face didn't bat an eyelash. He got up, ignored it, and he went on to dance. And he went around and he got some support from everybody who was watching. Now, I'm not saying that it's good to allow someone to just wave their hand in your face or mush you without putting that into place or checking that. That's not what I'm saying. But what was very interesting about me visualizing that was that he was not offended in the least. It didn't stop him from what he had to do. And he had a very strong character. The very fact that he didn't even respond to it made me look at him even more. It was very interesting. So when we look at our characters and when we look at the things that we don't like about ourselves, we always have an opportunity to change it, to modulate it, or to make the proper adjustment. And it is something that is within your power to do. So Gratitude is a lens. If you look at these glasses, and if they're dirty, I would have to clean them or wipe them off. But if I let the dirt and the filth stay on the glasses, I'm going to be looking through a tainted lens that's not going to give me a proper perspective of what is being presented before me. A lot of people have filth and dirt and other things on the lens of their perception, and it actually does change your life into something that you are not going to be gracious about. So take off your lenses, clean it up, and choose to live a life and look at life through the lens of gratitude. When you're able to do that, good things will happen in your life. You will be able to materialize things that are better for you into your life. And you will also have a much better relationship with people, with your environment, and with the purpose of your life in the first place. And remember, it is all a simple choice. As I observe everything that happens throughout the day, we are on social media. We're on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And I read the comments daily. And I see that there are a lot of people who don't have a job. They don't have a way to procure employment or finances into their life. Some people are very challenged with being able to make a living. And some people cannot afford to come to my seminars. They don't have the wherewithal or the liberty or the freedom to be able to get on a train, plane, or automobile to be present. And a lot of those people, I commiserate with you. So I have asked the gods and the angels for something that will allow those people who don't have the liberty to attend the seminars and the opulence of the events that Galighticus has all throughout the year. I wanted to make something available that is completely free and something that people could utilize to gain some kind of strength and empowerment in their life. And I asked this question months ago. And what I got when I asked the question was the Galighticus invocation. So here's how it works. The Galighticus invocation is something that you can read at the very beginning of your day, every day. It is something that is a list of codes that will bypass some of the challenges, soften some of the karma, and give you the benefit of your own word through your own utterance. It is something that your soul will give you a benefit if you adhere to it every single day. So no one has an excuse not to align themselves with a cause of light and love that is a movement right here on planet Earth. I hope this video has served you well. I am Sri Master Gano Grills for Galighticus.com, and I'll see you on the next episode. Namaste. Humming, 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 'cause your love has a coming now. Here it comes.